everyone, it's Lauren from Bodywork by Lauren Drake. Today I'm going to talk about pain and the specific question, has your pain become something that you can count on? This will by no means be a super deep dive on pain. Pain is super complicated, but it's I'm more going to talk about a recent personal revelation that I had that I think might be helpful to share. And I want to start by saying a few things. First is that pain sucks. Ow, right? It's not a pleasant experience. Two, pain is very real. And three, pain is information, right? It's a way in, it's a way to understand yourself. So I just want to say those things because I don't want what I'm about to say to make anybody feel like pain's easy to fix, or if you only thought about it in this certain way, then maybe you wouldn't have pain. Just to really underscore that pain is very complicated, neurobiologically, emotionally, all of the ways. Okay, so obviously there are different types of pain. With physical pain, there's chronic, there's acute, there's therapeutic, like hurt so good pain that you might experience when receiving manual work or even exercising. There's emotional pain, mental anguish, and I don't always think these are necessarily all that separate. You know, there are ways that they can become layered and coupled and just become this like super woven neural highway of information. But I do think that it can be helpful to learn to differentiate them when you are learning about yourself. Okay, so for my story, low back pain is an old, or has been an old friend of mine, I'd say probably for about a decade now, to various degrees. You know, it's always been one of those things that would come and go, flare up from time to time, be worse sometimes, not so bad others, but usually kind of always around and always around when I did certain things, like moved a certain way or did a certain movement in yoga, exacerbated by excessive sitting, that sort of thing. And recently, I had a source point session, one that was actually distance, and my back pain vanished. and this isn't a plug for source point, although I could talk about that, but it was a really confusing experience for me. It was, you know, welcomed because it didn't hurt anymore, but it was also just really astonishing and a little destabilizing because I realized I had really come to rely on it. I could count on that pain to be there because of this long-held relationship with my body behaving in a certain way. And because of that, I had to physically behave in certain ways to avoid that pain, like putting my hand on my knee when I bent over, or doing a grand plié just to pick something up off the floor. And I didn't have to do that anymore. So this newfound absence of pain came with other implications. It meant I had to physically behave differently. It actually became a new form of work that required my attention. It required that I had to move in different ways. Because guess what happened? I didn't. My brain wasn't prepared to start totally moving in a different way, and the pain came back. The pain returned because I continued to move through the world in ways that supported the painful state. At one time, they protected me from being in pain all the time, but in a sense, they were also keeping that pain in place. So this stuff is fascinating to me because I think that it has further-reaching meaning to other areas of our lives. Maybe you relate to this, or maybe you relate to it in a different way, like maybe you habitually crack your neck and you don't necessarily have to, or you habitually react to a person or a situation the same way every time and you don't have to, or you run a store, a narrative in your head that you've actually evolved past, but you keep running that groove. And we do all of these things in innocence, you know, but it just speaks to the ways that we limit ourselves without realizing it. So just back to pain being information, it's a spectrum, right? Whether it's like putting your hand on a hot stove and your body processing like, wow, this is really hot, I should remove my hand type of information, or this level of inquiry. Both are really crucial. And like I said, this level of inquiry is just a way to understand yourself. So to sum it up, I think there are a few takeaways from this. One being all of the myriad ways that we attempt to find steadfastness in a very unpredictable condition, which is being a human being alive in a body on planet Earth. You know, if you're looking for certainty, you came to the wrong place. Two, how you move matters. It's an extension of your psyche. And I'll even go a step further and really underline the importance of having an alignment-based movement practice, whether that's Pilates, yoga, Feldenkrais, Alexander. I mean, like, there are lots of different ways to do this. But it is a way to acquaint yourself with your body's tendencies and your body's tendencies to deviate from balance. And then three, kind of final, like, I think a more broad perspective is that when you shift a thing, all the other things around it have to shift with it. So just massive reorganization. You know, like the absence of pain, just, it's not a given. It means a lot of different other things. It takes energy and time and attention and trust and a willingness to emerge anew. So I hope there's a through line somewhere there for you. And maybe instills a sense of hope in you, like our ability to change and morph and shift is really quite powerful. So that's all I'm going to say. I hope it was helpful in some way. And thanks for listening. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.